So we're at 576. Randall, you're stuck on 576. Okay, you got no more cash. We can't lengthen the term. By the way, do I want to take the vehicle away from him?
No.
No, that's a desperation move. I might have to get there, but I ain't going there yet. I'm going to say, hey, Randall, I tell you what, I understand you don't want to write a check. In fact, I'm going to show you the graph. I've got the graphics in here that I'm going to write out so you can see them. What I'm going to do for Randall is I'm drawing right now a check. I'm saying, Randall, here's what you don't want to do. You don't want to write out a check for $576. You don't want to sign it. You do not want to send it to the bank. I understand. But what I'm going to say next is going to sound a little crazy, but it's the absolute truth. You're not going to pay $576 a month to drive this Gladiator, okay? You're going to pay substantially less than that. I'm going to show you the payment in a light that you may have never seen it before, but it's the absolute truth. Most people are worried about the bank keeping all their money. You would send that $576 check to the bank, you think it's all gone, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It's not. Okay? Look, everybody knows that the Gladiator is going to depreciate. It's not going to depreciate as much as most vehicles, but it's going to depreciate, right?
Mm-hmm.
What everybody doesn't know is that there's a savings element to every single car or truck payment you make. Because here's what's going to happen. You're going to make $576 a month payment 84 times. And then, after that 84th payment, Randall, what comes back to you in the mail?
Title.
A title. Except it's a special title because it's only got one name on it, and that is your name. It's called Free and Clear. Now, here's the question I've got for you. This is a $51,000 vehicle. Okay, it's going to depreciate, but it ain't going to depreciate like most vehicles. If you use it the way you intend on using it, what do you think at the end of 7 years it'll be worth?
Oh gosh, a Jeep, 25 grand.
So now that title is worth $25,000. And you know what? This title acts like a very expensive share of stock because you could trade it, couldn't you?
Mm-hmm.
You could sell it.
Yeah.
You could even borrow against it. But do me a favor, you got a telephone on you?
Mm-hmm.
Pull it out. Divide 25,000 by 84.
That was $297.61.
So we'll round it up to $298. Randall, do you know what that $298 represents?
Well, the part of the payment that's mine, that I keep.
So take 576 and subtract 298.
$278.
Randall, you're going to write a check for $576, but you're only paying $278 a month to drive that gorgeous vehicle. I need you to check mark right. Do you understand this? Truly.
I do.
Truly. Yeah.
You know what the number one customer response to this is?
Wow.
Do that again.
Yeah, exactly.
What do you mean?
Do that again.
Well, they forget about that part.
No, but how many salespeople do you know that?
But they never think of the damn end result.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I had never thought about it. I was 37 years in the business before someone showed this to me. I'd never seen it before. Now, let me tell you where it won't work. If somebody can't write the $576 check, it doesn't work. They'll just look at you and go, well, it may be $278, but I can't write the $576. Okay? Then we got them on the wrong vehicle for sure.
Right.
But this is designed to make it easier for your customer to say yes. Because when they're sitting in front of them, does the customer want to drive the Gladiator home?
Definitely.
Yes, they do.
Left a long time ago.
Yes, they want to drive it home. But you know what? Well, let me ask you this. What percentage of the new car customers do you think leave here with the highest payment they've ever had in their entire life? At least 80%. So there's a psychological barrier to this. I was at a Kia store in December, and I was working as a closer, and there was a couple, two engineers, and they had a problem with a $500 a month payment. They'd never had a $500 a month payment, and they couldn't say yes. So I went out and I showed them this. Well, they hooked. Half an hour later, I go back into the customer lounge to check out a football game, and they're over there with a yellow pad, and the guy waves me over. I go, oh, God. He says, he's got all these configurations on the yellow pad. They've taken everything that they're paying for on time and applied the same formula to it. The guy looks at me and goes, I believe my house payment's negative. Because it's going to appreciate. So it's, I mean, the mathematics are absolutely correct. You'll blow the customer away. But it's the truth. And you have to, there's little words that you have to make sure that you use. I said, Randall, you're only going to pay $278 to drive the vehicle. To drive the vehicle. Okay? And this is great for new cars. It's not even fair on used cars because so much of the depreciation's already taken place. Right, I mean, you kill it on the used car side. It's a beautiful thing. A beautiful way to help a customer say yes and go ahead and sign. One guy said, can I tell my wife it's $278? I said, as long as you use the term net, okay? Because that's your net payment.
Where'd you drive it over the curb?
I'm
just
kidding.
No,
you're not.
All right, does this make sense?
Yes, it does.
Okay, you guys break for like 10 minutes, and I'm going to load up these videos.